Hey, what is up, YouTube? Jacob Lovin here, and today we are finally doing a answering your questions video. I've been looking forward to doing this. I've got my favorite notebook, which has about, I'd say, 8 videos worth of content in it, and a couple of those are answering your questions. And one person clicked like on my Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom trailer, the second one. They clicked like, so now I'm stuck wearing this hat. So let's get started with our first question. If I can find it. And our first question is from Chance Parkinson, who asks me, what was the tallest dinosaur? Well, as far as I'm aware, I think the tallest dinosaur is a dinosaur named Soro Poseidon, which means lizard earthquake god. And this thing was big. It was like 80 to 90 feet tall. How big was it? Some ranges will put it at 65 to 80 feet tall. I'd say it could have gotten bigger, but who knows? Though, Mamenchisaurus, some certain species have been known to get taller. I hope that answers your question, Chance, because really, that's a hard one. I have not heard what the tallest dinosaur is. To me, it's Soro Poseidon. And, well, let's get started with more questions. My next question is from Aaron Elsie, of course. Aaron, I really appreciate your questions. They give me, in fact, some of your questions are the questions I'm going to make discussion topics out of. So thank you, Aaron. Thank you for that. And she asks me, which dinosaur is the most active during the day and at night? Well, for daytime, it's mostly herbivorous dinosaurs. So you're thinking animals like Triceratops, Stegosaurs, Sauropods, Hadrosaurids, Iguanodonts, Ankylosaurs. Those are mostly ones who you'd see during the day. Especially some carnivores such as T-Rex, Spinosaurus, Carcharodontosaurus. Plenty of animals hunted during the day as well. But as far as nocturnal dinosaurs go, the one dinosaur I am almost 100% sure on that hunted during the night was Troodon, and any other of the raptor family. These animals had very big orbits, which means they could hold big eyeballs. And the bigger your eyes are, the better you can see at night. Because the bigger your eye is, the more light comes into your eye and you can see a lot clearer, which is why, unfortunately, I have to use glasses because my eyes aren't that big. I have to use glasses. So to your question, what animals were active during the day? Mostly big predators and large herbivores, as well as the small ones. And which ones were active during night? Mostly small carnivores like raptors and maybe even smaller herbivores. In fact, some mammals have actually been known to be nocturnal in the time of the dinosaurs. So, there's a little fact for you I bet you didn't know. My next question is from someone named Andre? They didn't put their last name, unfortunately. But they asked me, what would long-necked dinosaurs do during a lightning storm? That is a great question. That is a really good question. Because these animals, the long-necked dinosaurs, sauropods, their heads are way up, so close to the clouds. So it wouldn't take much for a stray lightning bolt to just hit them in the head and kill the poor thing. My best guess for these animals is either they laid in tree cover, you know, they went into the forest and tried to blend in with all the trees, hopefully tried to duck down a bit, or they went into the open areas, wide open areas, and they were kind of trying to lie down, so it was a lot less possible for them to get struck by lightning. Which is what a lot of modern day animals do today, especially us. What we do in a lightning storm is we either head inside, or if we're stuck out in the middle of nowhere, we hide in a big open field. So, Andre, that was a great question, by the way. I love people who give me such good questions, ones that I really like about. That's really nice. And this next one is from Brie Nicole. Brianna Nicole? I don't know. I can't read it sometimes. I can't read people's language, especially without my glasses. And the reason I'm not wearing my glasses is because there's light reflecting off my glasses, which interferes with the camera. But she asked me, how big is a dinosaur? Which is just a random question, but it depends on your dinosaur. There are dinosaurs that can be smaller than pigeons, so about probably that big. And then there are dinosaurs that could be as big as whales. So you got basically the smallest dinosaurs all the way up to the biggest. And you can bet that there's a dinosaur that fills in every bit of that size range. And I hope that answers your question, Bree. It's really hard to answer questions when, you know, you don't have a lot of detail in them. Let's see, who else? How long was a... Oh, Lord. Who wrote that? Brandon Cook? Seriously, dude? What's wrong with you? Why do people always ask these vulgar kind of questions? These are nasty. But he asks me, how long was a dinosaur's penis? And that is a very vulgar question. I don't know if I should answer it, but I'm going to. Just because he took the time to write it, and I just don't feel right turning down somebody who, you know, wanted to know something. Oh, boy. Okay, so. Really, the size depends on the dinosaur, okay? I've heard theories of large sauropods having penises that the size of about two stories tall. And when you consider that an elephant today, African elephants have six foot long penises, I'm not surprised. But really, two stories seems a bit overkill. Oh boy. So, Brandon, really, it just depends on the size of the dinosaur. How big the dinosaur is differs to how big its, you know, what is. Okay, that is just so messed up. I'm going to wrap this up. Whoa, that is a very disturbing question. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I didn't. Oh, boy. But leave a like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell down by the subscribe button. Don't forget to leave any questions. If you're not a person who goes to my school, leave your questions in the comment section so I may add them to my list in my notebook. Until that time, I will see you in the next video. Take care. Aloha.